Do you think these things are really gonna work?
They should. They worked last time. Let's go try here.
Okay.
Yes, for the near baby.
On Friday then?
Yes, 1 o'clock.
1 o'clock?
Okay, Chance.
See you later.
Bye-bye. Hi, can I help you?
Yeah, can we have 2 beers?
I'll need to see some ID. I'm sorry, I can't accept these. I'm gonna have to hold them while I call the police.
Hi, I'm Secretary of State George Ryan. What you have just viewed is an all too familiar scene. Underage drinking is a serious and widespread problem. Nationally, nearly 2,500 teenagers were killed in alcohol-related crashes in 1992. Here in Illinois, nearly 3,000 drivers under the age of 21 were convicted of illegal transportation of alcohol. Additionally, among our nation's young people, almost half of all the deaths, drownings, fires, suicides and homicides are alcohol related. A Surgeon General's survey found that almost two-thirds of students who drink buy their own alcohol, often using fake IDs. My office is very concerned about this. We have observed a great deal of fraudulent activity on our Illinois college campuses and in surrounding communities. And in some schools in the northwest suburbs, as many as 30% of the students have fictitious licenses. Secretary of State Police have made many arrests and recovered hundreds of fake licenses. The use of fraudulent identification not only leads to alcohol-related incidents, but to other illegal activities, such as cashing bogus checks. Operation Straight ID focuses on stopping the use and production of fake IDs and driver's licenses. With the training you will receive through Operation Straight ID, you'll be able to detect fake IDs and assist law enforcement prosecuting the individuals who manufacture and use them. I hope you find this video informative, and I want to thank you for joining forces with us in Operation Straight ID.
The Office of the Secretary of State issues 3 distinctive documents that are uniformly accepted by society as photographic identification: the driver's license, commercial driver's license, and identification card. While the purpose of each of these documents is slightly different, the design remains relatively similar. The type of document is identified in the upper right-hand area of the document, immediately above the photo of the bearer. The words driver's license or letters CDL are printed in blue on a white background. The letters ID are printed in white on a blue background. Directly to the left of this area, George H. Ryan, Secretary of State, clearly appears in royal blue on a white background. The lettering is approximately 1/16 of an inch in height. Studies of confiscated look-alike documents have shown that counterfeiters often will not duplicate this area accurately. Instead, this area on fraudulent versions often will be of poor clarity, appearing blurred with a softer powder blue coloring. Directly below George H. Ryan, Secretary of State, is the document number and the document's expiration date. The number assigned to the bearer by the Office of the Secretary of State consists of 12 characters. On driver's licenses and commercial driver's licenses, the first character is the first letter of the bearer's last name. The letter is followed by 11 numbers. Identification card numbers differ slightly from those assigned to licenses. Instead of appearing as the first character of the number, the first letter of the bearer's last name appears in the 12th position, or at the conclusion of the sequence. Other areas of importance on the number include the first 3 numerical positions. This number is never larger than 666. The 7th and 8th numerical positions display the bearer's year of birth. When examining a document to determine authenticity, the year of birth on the document should be compared to this section of the document number to assure that the numbers are the same. Any deviation may indicate the document has been altered and should not be accepted. Directly to the right of the number, the expiration date of the document is highlighted in yellow. The month and day are usually the same as the bearer's date of birth. The only exception to this rule is that a driver's license or identification card will not expire on the holder's 21st birthday. In instances where the holder is about to turn 21, the document will expire 3 months past the holder's 21st birthday. Directly below the number and expiration date is the bearer's name and address. Directly below this area and slightly to the right is an area assigned for the bearer's Social Security number. This display of the Social Security number on the document is voluntary, and no number will appear should the holder decide not to have the number printed on the document. Directly below this area is the bearer's height, weight, sex, whether the bearer has joined the organ tissue donor registry, and date of birth. The date of birth is highlighted in yellow. Below this line of information is an area with other miscellaneous information, such as issue date, class of driver, type applicant, endorsements, and restrictions. Directly below the issue date is a 9-character sequence that can be used by the Office of the Secretary of State to identify the location of the facility in which a specific document was issued. The first 3 numerical positions will never be a sequence larger than 320. Directly below this control number is the area assigned for the signature. A photograph of the bearer is located in the lower right corner of the document. The applicant's photograph, which is in the shape of the state of Illinois, is taken from approximately the neck up. The background of the photograph will be either blue or red. The red background is used exclusively for applicants that are under the age of 21. At the top left side of the photo, a 3-digit security number appears vertically. These 3 digits are approximately 1/16 of an inch in height and evenly spaced. This feature is designed to prevent the fraudulent insertion of different photographs. When examining the document to determine authenticity, this digit should be examined to assure that it does not appear to have been broken or cut. Additionally, the color and clarity of this number will be consistent with other areas on the document, such as the words birth, type, sex, etc. Studies of counterfeit look-alike licenses have shown that counterfeiters often will not successfully duplicate this area of the license. These areas on counterfeit documents often appear blurry and dull and lack overall consistency of color. A multi-dimensional hologram covers the date of birth and overlaps the photo. When tilted at different angles, the hologram shows either the head of the Lincoln penny or seal of the state of Illinois. A plastic laminate protects the document. This laminate is designed with several security features to prevent unlawful alterations. The laminate is sealed at the time of issue and cannot be reopened without the words Polaroid appearing throughout the document. The word Illinois is printed vertically on the laminate along the left side of the document. The letters are blue for drivers age 21 and over, and red for drivers under age 21. Throughout this video, we have discussed the new Illinois driver's license and identification cards. These new documents were first issued January 1st, 1994, and will be phased in over a 5-year period. Until that time, it is helpful to be familiar with both the new and old documents. To report driver's license or identification card violations, contact your local police agency or the Illinois Secretary of State Police at 800-608-0561. This toll-free hotline is staffed 24 hours a day. Each agency or organization participating in Operation Straight ID training will receive a 17-by-22-inch poster displaying samples of various Illinois driver's licenses and identification cards. These posters are sequentially numbered and will only be provided to attendees of the Operation Straight ID seminars.